Well, Brendan, this is a treat, a chance to sit down to the owner of the Bayhawks. You've owned them since 2010, and you've really taken this organization to a different level. But much like we discussed with Mark, this weekend is going to be special, July 2nd at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. Yep. Beyond just the game, which is a big game for your team, what you're doing with some of the hometown heroes and military appreciation, yep. I know something close to your heart.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we play at Navy Marine Corps Stadium, which is a dedication to our military, so it's a unique place to play. So 5 years ago, we decided to do a military appreciation night. We wear special helmets, guys autograph them, we do an auction afterwards, we make a donation back to military affiliation that's going to help our vets. I mean, it's, you know, the people, we want to honor the folks that are fighting for our country, and what a better place to do it than Navy Marine Corps Stadium.
How have you sort of seen and learned that with the position you have with this team, beyond the winning that you've done on the field, it's given you a chance to give back to this community, one that, again, is a place that is very special to you?
Yeah, obviously, born and raised in Annapolis. It's sitting here at Cantlers.
Yeah, it's pretty wild.
Pretty wild. It's a hometown place. Cantlers has been on board with us since day one as a sponsor, so it's a great place to be, and obviously being on the water here. But the fan base has been great. I mean, that's the biggest thing. When I bought the team in 10, the community really rallied around, supported the Bayhawks. And, you know, obviously we put up championships in 10, 13, or 12 and 13. So we're the winningest franchise around, so it's hard not to support it. But the community has been unbelievable. And that's something that, we want to give back to the community. This July 2nd game with having a concert, having the fireworks afterwards, which is a big deal. When I was a kid, actually, they used to do the 4th of July fireworks in the stadium, so it's a little bit of a throwback.
Okay.
Believe it or not, they used to light them off on the 50-yard line. They'd fill the stadium and light them off on the 50-yard line, so they don't. Wouldn't,
I was
going to
say,
they
might not let you do that now.
No, but it's really a throwback, so a lot of people have brought that up to me in the community that, oh, maybe we used to do this here. It used to be an all-day tradition at Navy Stadium to go out, picnic all day, and do the fireworks. So each year, we've kind of added to that. And I'll be honest with you, I mean, the Denver Outlaws out west have done a phenomenal job on the July 4th game. You know, I know they're expecting 40,000 plus. So our goal, obviously, in this community is to get to that 40,000 plus eventually in Field Navy Stadium.
No, I think it's one of the unique things about the league each summer. Obviously, Denver's kind of the headliner, but it becomes a special weekend across the league. While I have you here, I mean, when you look at the league right now and you look at your team, things seem to be in flux. The positivity of the play is off the charts. As you look at it now, 7 years in, what stands out to you?
I think that there's actually more talent than there are teams right now. So I think expansion is inevitable for us, right? I mean, you look at the records last year, I think it was six of the teams were
8-6.
Right?
It was unbelievable.
This year is the same problem. And you look at our, talk with Coach Reese, you look at our roster, our 25-man roster is as deep as it ever been. I feel for him a little bit. He's got tough choices to make each week, right? Because it's not an easy place to be. Obviously, I've been there as a coach in the league. But so the talent is just outstanding. And then these young guys that are coming in aren't, 6 foot and 195 pounds anymore. They're 6'4", 210 pounds, and run like deer. So, you know, it's a really unique time for the league. And we have the best players in the world. I mean, that's the most unique thing about our sport, really, when you look at it. I mean, MLS has, the best players and the soccer players are in Europe, yeah. Right? For us, we have the best lacrosse players in the world playing here in MLL. So, and the talent's only growing because of the growth of the sport, the youth, high school, and collegiate level. So we're excited, but I think we're ready for expansion as a league. New commissioner coming on board next year, new vision for the league, and I think it's a really exciting time to be part of the MLL.
One other thing on the horizon, and one thing we're all hopeful for, is that there'll be a Bayhawks stadium in
Me
the
too.
Coming years,
yeah.
in Crownsville, not very, yeah. far from where we are right now.
Yeah.
What can you tell us in terms of the meetings you're having and the energy you're trying to generate for this project?
Yeah, I mean, I think the Governor Hogan, County Executive Steve Hsu have been exceptional to work with. I think they've done a really good job. Crownsville is a very difficult site. A lot of issues out there from a construction standpoint, some history standpoint, obviously. But I think it's the right project, and I think it's the right place for it. So we'll be patient and work with them also. But I think eventually, it's 544 acres. So it could end up becoming the massive sports complex in the country. So it's a really unique opportunity for the state of Maryland, for Anne Arundel County, and certainly for the Chesapeake Bayhawks. So we believe that the stadium is really the first real jumping stone for this league that's going to take it to a whole new level. So we already have a lot of interest in some naming rights partners, have some meetings set up down in the next coming months to talk to them about the entire park. And I think that, as you look at Columbus, Ohio, start really, the MLS was the first kind of light of the firecracker for the MLS come stadium-wise. We want to be the same. We also would like to have the Hall of Fame, the first MLL Hall of Fame, and turn it into a Canton kind of feel. for the MLL lacrosse here. So when we're not playing in season, it's a place to visit and kind of see the whole MLL experience. So it's exciting times, and you know, I couldn't be happier for it to be happening in the state of Maryland.
And that makes a ton of sense. And I don't think a lot of fans realize that unless you have your own property, a lot of money's going out that you can't really recoup, because when you're renting from, again, a great venue at Navy, but you're running out of revenue streams.
Well, there's two real issues with Navy. A, we don't own it, we don't control it. And then B, it's just too big for us, right? We're looking to build a 10,000-seat stadium that we sell out every week. The 40,000-seat stadium is just not going to work right now. And, you know, again, the July 2nd game, that's our hope. So the ideal goal would be we build a new stadium and we play the July military night game at Navy, probably long term, based on the fact that it's going to be more than 10,000 people a game, which we're expecting this week. So we're excited.